Hello friends, in this video lecture I want to explain half adder and full adder. From the definition till the design. Now basically all types of adders are combinational circuit which are entirely different from that of sequential circuits. In case of combinational circuit, that output depends on current input only. They do not require any memory element which is built in. Or even the combinational circuit does not require any clock signal to change its output state. Now let us start here. The basic half adder, first of all, the definition. Now as the definition which is shown on the screen, it performs the addition of two single bit numbers. The numbers are designated as say A and B and generate two single bit outputs, which is sum output and carry output. It clearly means that variable A, variable B, that will define two inputs and the output variable will be sum and carry. Now on the subsequent line, in order to show the block diagram of that half adder, you will find that inputs A, B are applied from the left side, while to the right side that output of sum and that corresponding output carry are obtained. Now here that block diagram that is shown as a single block which you can observe it, half adder. As stated just above this particular say block here, that inputs A, B to be applied from the left side, which are single bit numbers, and then on the right side that sum and carry output, single bit sum and single bit carry output are obtained. Normally in case of any digital circuit, it is a method or it is a practice that inputs are shown from the left side and output will be obtained on the right side, left to right. Now in this particular slide, the truth table to be generated, the equations to be written and then the logical diagram that is to be developed. So let us once again write here, the two inputs A, B which are applied from the left side, sum and carry outputs are shown in this particular truth table, and that truth table I want to develop it now in a gradual manner. So let us see here, there are four columns, variable A, variable B, inputs, then sum and carry, these are the two outputs which are clearly shown in these four columns. Initially, whenever inputs are A and B, both are 0, 0. So 0 plus 0, using binary addition rule, we know that sum will be 0 and carry will be 0, which is subsequently written in that same row which you can observe it. So when inputs are 0, 0, sum 0, carry 0. Next combination, A is 0 but B is 1. 0 plus 1, sum will be 1 and carry will be 0, which is subsequently written on the right side. Then next is 1, 0, 1 plus 0, sum is 1 and carry is equal to 0. And then the last combination, which is at the bottom of this particular truth table, that is 1, 1, 1 plus 1. Sum is equal to 0 and carry output will be 1. So this is the way that truth table can be developed for the half adder using binary addition rules, which are very simple, we have already covered up. Now next, I want to develop that output equation on the right side. So first of all, that output equation for the sum output. there are two outputs, sum and carry. Out of that, sum output equation has been written here. Okay, you are not supposed to confuse here how this particular sum equation has been written. Okay, you just need to observe that column of that sum output here. That sum output is equal to 1 at two instances. The first instance, whenever A is equal to 0 and B is equal to 1. Okay, that's why my first term in that sum equation written here, that is equal to A bar B. A 0 means A bar, B 1 means B. A bar B is my first term when my sum is equal to 1. Second instance, when that sum is equal to 1, when A is equal to 1 but B is equal to 0, so my second term will be A B bar. And these two terms are connected by using OR operator plus sign in between. So sum equation is basically A bar B plus A B bar. And this is nothing but the equation of XOR gate, we know that. So A XOR B is the simplified equation, one can write it here on the right side. So this is for the sum output. Similarly, for the carry output, we need to write the second equation. Fortunately for that carry output, that last column in the truth table, only at one instant that carry output is equal to 1, and that is when A and B, both the inputs are 1, 1. That's why carry output equation, that is equal to AB here. A is equal to 1 and B is equal to 1. So equation for that carry output is equal to AB. Now once I get these output equations here, then the last step, that is the logical diagram, the design. So here is the heading, logical diagram of half adder is. Okay, that will be gradually developed in this space which is shown here. Now, first of all, about that sum. You can observe that sum equation is nothing but A XOR B. So, a single XOR gate having two inputs, where variable A and variable B are connected as input from the left side, and the output of that XOR gate will be giving that sum output on the right side. Okay, again, the inputs A, B required even for the generation of carry. That's why same inputs are taken down and are connected to one AND gate, two input AND gate, and the output of that AND gate will be generating that final carry here, carry output. So this is the design of that half adder by using one XOR gate and one AND gate, which is realized, which is shown here. So this is all about the design of that half adder here. Next, is a full adder the definition and block diagram which is to be shown in this particular slide. Now, what is the definition of full adder that is appearing on the screen in green color? It performs the addition of three single bit numbers, number A, number B, and C in, and generates two outputs here, sum output and the carry output. Okay, it clearly means that here the three bits of input will be applied and two bits of output will be generated. So next line, from the left side, the regular inputs, that is variable A, variable B, along with that input carry C in, are applied. While to the right side, that output, that is sum output S, and the carry output C out are obtained, and it is shown below. So here is that corresponding block, full adder block. It is a block diagram. Only one need to show from the left side the inputs, input variables, and to the right side their corresponding output generated variables. So here are the inputs. Inputs from that corresponding full adder, variable A, variable B, and C in. Normally, that C in is input carry. And on the right side here of that particular block diagram, it will be showing that sum output S, the upper output, and then the carry output, that is C out. It is the output carry. So normally the conventions within that full adder, C in stands for input carry, and C out, that stands for output carry. And the other regular inputs are A and B, and other regular output obtained, that is S, that is sum output. Now in this particular slide, the next slide, truth table is to be developed in a gradual manner, and then we have to write down the output equations. So here in this particular truth table, the three inputs are to be shown, A, B, and C in. Okay, let me define in a single column all the inputs together. It is quite possible to show it in a single column or three separate columns. And then on the output side here, sum output and carry output, that is my second column in this particular truth table, which I am going to develop. Initially, whenever A, B, C, N, all are 0, 0, 0. Using binary addition rule here, A plus B plus C in, 0 plus 0 plus 0, sum output is equal to 0 and carry output is also 0, which is subsequently written on the output side. Next, 0, 0, 1. 0 plus 0 plus 1, the second entry, second row in this truth table. So output sum will be 1 and carry output will be 0, which is subsequently written here. Then next to that, the binary, next combination will be 0, 1, 0. So 0 plus 1 plus 0, which will appear now. Again that sum will be 1 and carry output will be 0 here. What does it mean? Whatever inputs which are shown on the left side here, their corresponding three bits are added together by using binary addition rule, and then that corresponding sum and output carry are written there. Okay, so that way my next entry will be 1 0 0 0 1 1. So 0 plus 1 plus 1, it clearly means that 1 plus 1 basically. So sum output will be 0 and carry is equal to 1. Carry output is equal to 1. Next entry will be 1, 0, 0. 1 plus 0 plus 0. Sum will be 1, carry output 0. Then sixth row, that is 1, 0, 1. That is 1 plus 0 plus 1. Effectively 1 plus 1. Sum is equal to 0, output carry is equal to 1. Then the next entry, next row, 1, 1, 0, that is 1 plus 1 plus 0, effectively 1 plus 1, sum is equal to 0 and carry is equal to 1. And then the last row in this truth table here, that is 1 plus 1 plus 1, which is shown at the bottom, here my truth table terminates. So for the last entry here, 1 plus 1 plus 1, sum is equal to 1 and carry output is also 1. So once I write down their corresponding outputs for each possible combination of input like this, that truth table is over. Then I have to write down those output equations. Now within that output equation, first of all, I have to develop the output equation for the sum output here. Sum. But sum output, you can observe it at four places. The second row, the third row, then the fifth row, and last, that is the eighth row. That sum output is equal to 1. And for each of that 1 here, I have to write down their corresponding input combination as a part of that output equation. So initially, from the top, in the second row itself, that sum output is equal to 1. And for that second row, input combinations will be 0, 0, 1, means A0, so A bar, B0, B bar, and C is C in 1, so it is C in. So my first term which is to be written in that sum equation here, that is A bar, B bar, and C in. Why it is so? Whenever any variable is 0, it is to be shown with bar. Okay, so for the first entry where my sum output is equal to 1, where A is equal to 0, B is equal to 0, C in is equal to 1, so A bar, B bar, C in. My first term over. Next term, in the subsequent row that sum output is equal to 1, and you will backtrack and see what are their input combinations there. A is equal to 0, B is equal to 1, C in is equal to 0. So it is A bar, B, C in bar. So my next term here plus A bar, B, C in bar. Okay, every such term is to be connected by using a plus sign by OR operator. Now next to that, that sum output is equal to 1. In the fifth row from the top, where A is equal to 1, B and C in both 0. So its equation will become A, B bar, C in bar. So my next term which is to be added in that sum on the right side is A, B bar, C in bar. And then the last row here, the eighth row, the bottom row, when sum is equal to 1, where A, B and C in all are 1. So my next term which is to be added here in that sum equation will be A, B, C in, which is written at the end of that equation here. It means that within that sum equation, sum output equation here, there will be total 4 terms, because within that column at 4 places my sum output is equal to 1. And accordingly, input combinations will be referred and that corresponding term has been written here. Now, this equation which we obtain for this sum, it can be minimized by using any minimization method. Like say, using Boolean algebra, using De Morgan's theorem, that minimization can be done. K-map method of minimization can be used. Quinn-McCluskey method of minimization can be used. Of course, Mumbai University for Computer Engineering. In the revised syllabus, that Quinn-McCluskey method or K-map method of minimization has not been included. It means that Mumbai University students should minimize this particular sum equation only by using the Boolean algebra. I will write down just that end minimized equation here just below this. So my sum equation after minimization, it would be like this: A XOR B XOR C in. It clearly means that in order to get that sum output here, I require a 3 input XOR gate, where the inputs applied will be A, B and C in. Then next to that, the equation for that carry output, carry, is to be similarly obtained. Again, in that carry output column here, you just count at how many places we are getting that logic 1 output here. Again at 4 places. The first instance when that carry output is equal to 1, that is in the 4th row from the top, where inputs are 0, 1, 1. A0 means A bar, B1 means B, C in 1 means C in. So A bar, B, C in, that is my first term here, A bar, B, C in, which is written on the right side. Then the next entry where that carry output is equal to 1, that is in the 6th row where A, B, C in are 1, 0, 1. So that corresponding term will be A, B bar, C in. So this term is added. Added on the right side, you can observe it. Plus A, B bar, C in. Now next to that, the 7th row, that carry output is equal to 1, where A, B, C in are 1, 1, 0. So equation would be A, B, C in bar. That is added. That is added on the right side in that output carry here. And then the last row, that carry output is equal to 1, where that A, B, C in all are 1. So my last term here will be A, B, C in. That is also to be added in that output carry equation. It means that output carry equation also contains a total 4 terms which are connected by using OR operator. Plus sign means OR operator. And if this particular equation is minimized, then after minimization, I am getting equations like this. So output carry is AB plus AC in plus BC in. It clearly means that AB, one AND gate required. AC in, second AND gate required. BC in, third AND gate is required. And the outputs of these three AND gates individually connected together by using one OR gate. So this output carry equation can be realized, that can be designed by using AND gates, three AND gates followed by one OR gate. Whereas sum, the earlier equation, that is realized by using a single XOR gate, but that should be of three input. So this particular design, which will now come on the next slide. So here, full adder, the equations once again to be revisited, and then that logical diagram, that particular design that is to be subsequently followed. So here is the equation for that sum which we have already developed, simplified by using any one method of simplification, minimization, and I am getting A XOR B XOR C in as a simplified sum equation. And then on the right side, that logical diagram will be subsequently followed for some part of that particular design. You can observe it, A, B, C in are the inputs which are given to that 3 input XOR gate. And that XOR gate's output will be sum output here. And then A, B, C in, those are also taken here for the generation of carry output, which is to be built as per the equation which I am going to rewrite here. So here, below that sum is a carry output. The basic terms are written here, and after minimization, that carry output is equal to AB plus AC in plus BC in. That minimized equation has been written here. And then these terms, minimized terms which we are going to use it for here for the generation of that output carry. First of all, AB. You can observe it one AND gate, where that input B and input A are applied. A, B are applied. Sequence is not important. Commutative law states that sequence is not important in case of AND gate. So here, first AND gate, its output will be AB here. Second AND gate, its output should be AC in as per the equation which is shown to the left side for the carry here. So second AND gate, the inputs which are applied will be AC in. And then there will be third AND gate which is shown at the bottom, where that inputs will be BC in. Okay, it means that in order to realize the equation of that output carry, which is written on the left side, the second equation, three AND gates are used here. Each of that AND gate will be giving a particular term, and then these three terms will be connected by using plus operator, means OR operator. So the outputs of these three AND gates are connected together, merged together by using OR gate. So here is that corresponding OR gate, you can observe it. Outputs of AND gate, those are merged together, and then this OR gate will be giving that final carry output here, C out. So this is the logical diagram or the design of that corresponding full adder, right from the truth table till this particular design here. Now sometimes question can be asked to design that full adder by using two half adders. So here is that corresponding heading which we want to discuss. So here is that full adder design by cascading two half adders. Okay, let us gradually develop it. Now here two half adders are to be used. Out of that first half adder, which is to be shown on the left side, extreme left side, that performs the addition of two single bit numbers, the regular inputs, input A and input B. Okay, this half adder, now I want to show it on extreme left, that space which is available. So here is that first half adder, where the inputs applied will be AB, and below that half adder, just that input carry has been shown, still not connected. Now next, on the right side, in blue color, second half adder, which is to be shown in the middle. Okay, the term middle in the bracket indicates that second half adder, which is to be shown in the middle in the left side diagram, that performs the addition of some bit of that first adder, S bit, some bit of that first adder along with input carry C, which is shown here. So let me show that particular connection of that second half adder here. So here is that second half adder, sum is connected to that second half adder as one of the input, and second input for that second half adder, that is Cin, input carry. On the right side, next line, the third line, that second half adder generates that final sum output of that full adder here. It means that second half adder, which is shown in the middle, its S, means sum output, will be the final sum output here. That is the final sum output which you can observe it now. Okay, next to that will be about that carry, because full adder also requires one carry output here, output carry here. So the next line which is shown on the right side here, that carry generated by both the half adders are merged together by using OR gate, and that will be generating that final carry here, output carry here, C out. So that merging is shown here. Merging of individual carry output bits of half adders together by using